Hi there, and welcome to another video. Today's video is about 9 rarest meteorites. So without further ado, let's begin. Top of the list is the fuking meteorite. The fuking meteorite is a meteorite that was found in the mountains near Fuking, China in 2000. It is a pellicite, a type of stony iron meteorite with olivine crystals. It is in 2000, near Fuking, China, a Chinese dealer obtained a mass from Xinjiang province, China, with a weight of 1,003 kilograms. He removed about 20 kilograms from the main mass, and in February 2005, the meteorite was taken to the Tucson Gem and Mineral Show, where it was seen by Dr. Dante Loretta, a professor of planetary science and cosmochemistry at the University of Arizona. The Fuking pellicite contains large, gem-quality olivine, or peridot, in a nickel-iron matrix. The olivines vary in shape from rounded to angular, many are fractured, and they range in size from less than 5 millimeters to several centimeters. A section weighing 31 kilograms of type specimen is on deposit at the University of Arizona. Marvin Kilgore holds an additional section weighing the same amount, as well as the balance of the main mass. In April 2008, Bonhams offered the main mass for auction at their Manhattan auction. Bonhams expected to fetch $1 million, but the lot remained unsold. Coming up next is Brenham meteorite. Brenham is a pellicite meteorite found near Haviland, a small town in Kiowa County, Kansas, United States. Pellicites are a type of stony, iron meteorite that when cut and polished show yellowish olivine crystals. The Brenham meteorite is associated with the Haviland crater. In 1949, a collector named Ho Stockwell discovered a mass of 453.6 kilograms known at the time as the world's largest pellicite meteorite. In October 2005, geologist Philip Manny and meteorite hunter Steve Arnold located and recovered the largest fragment ever found of Brenham, a single pellicite mass of 650 kilograms. A large collection of Brenham meteorites, along with numerous fragments weighing a total of 8,500 pounds, were once housed at the now-closed Kansas Meteorite Museum and Nature Center in Haviland, Kansas. Coming up is the Willamette meteorite. The Willamette meteorite, officially named Willamette and originally known as Tominowos by the Clackamas Chinook Native American tribe, is an iron-nickel meteorite found in the U.S., state of Oregon. It is the largest meteorite found in the United States and the sixth largest in the world. There was no impact crater at the discovery site. Researchers believe the meteorite landed in what is now Canada or Montana and was transported as a glacial erratic to the Willamette Valley during the Missoula floods at the end of the last ice age. Having been seen by an estimated 40 million people over the year, the Willamette meteorite weighs about 15,500 kilograms. It is classified as a type 3 iron meteorite, being composed of over 91% iron and 7.62% nickel, with traces of cobalt and phosphorus. Willamette has a recrystallized structure with only traces of a medium Widmanstätten pattern. It is the result of a significant impact heating event on the parent body. A 4.5-ounce and 7.5-inches piece of the meteorite, also with a Makovich collection provenance, was purchased in a 2006 auction and was displayed at the Evergreen Aviation and Space Museum in McMinnville, Oregon until it was returned to the Confederated Tribes of the Grand Ronde on February 22, 2019. Next is the Conception Junction meteorite. Conception Junction is one of 22 pellicite meteorites discovered in the United States and is named after the location in which it was found. Our offered specimens are slices from the only found stone, weighing only 17 kilograms. On number 5 is Springwater meteorite. The Springwater meteorite is a stony iron pellicite, found near Springwater, Saskatchewan in 1931. At that time, the find consisted of three large masses, 38.6 kilograms, 18.6 kilograms, and 10.6 kilograms. Other fragments have been found recently, including a 53 kilograms individual in 2009 that is now in the Royal Ontario Museum. 30% of the meteorite is the iron-rich metallic phases camasite and tenite, with the rest mostly made up of olivine. There are minor amounts of other minerals, including several phosphates such as ferringtonite and stanfieldite and merylite, which is a member of the whitlakite group. Sixth position is taken by Chelyabinsk meteorite. The Chelyabinsk meteorite is the fragmented remains of the large Chelyabinsk meteor of the 15th of February 2013, which reached the ground after the meteor's passage through the atmosphere. The descent of the meteor, visible as a brilliant superbolide in the morning sky, caused a series of shock waves that shattered windows, damaged approximately 7,200 buildings and left 1,491 people injured. The resulting fragments were scattered over a wide area. the largest fragment raised from the bottom of Lake Chebarkul on the 16th of October 2013 had a mass of 540 kilograms, and the total mass of other seven meteorite fragments found nearby was 84.4 kilograms. The meteorite has been classified as an LL5 ordinary chondrite. First estimates of its composition indicate about 10% of meteoric iron, as well as olivine and sulfides. Scientists collected 53 samples from near a 6-meter-wide hole in the ice of Lake Chebarkul, thought to be the result of a single meteorite fragment impact. In the aftermath of the superbolide air burst, a large number of small meteorite fragments fell on areas west of Chelyabinsk, including Deputetskoy, generally at terminal velocity, about the speed of a piece of gravel drop from a skyscraper. Local residents and schoolchildren located and picked up some of the meteorites, many located in snowdrifts, by following a visible hole that had been left in the outer surface of the snow. Coming up is the Dar Al-Ghani. The Dar Al-Ghani, also known as Dag, is a meteorite field in the Libyan Sahara. The site is a plateau of limestone, about 200 kilometers long and 60 kilometers at its widest. Dark-colored meteorites can be easily spotted in this field, where they have also been well-preserved due to the arid climate and favorable geology consisting of basic rocks and lacking erosive quartz sand. As of July 2001, 869 meteorites with a total weight of 687 kilograms were retrieved from the site. The largest weighed 95 kilograms. The name Dar Al-Ghani was given by the Nomenclature Committee of the Meteoritical Society. It does not exist in the National Atlas of Libya. However, the name Dur Al-Ghani was given to part of the Sarir Al-Qadusa Plateau in the geological map of Libya. On number 8, the main mass of Zagami meteorite. Zagami is the largest single Martian meteorite ever found, weighing about 18 kilograms. It landed 10 feet from a farmer near Zagami, Nigeria, and became buried in a hole about 2 feet deep. According to Ron Balk of NASA or JPL, the Zagami meteorite is the most easily obtainable SNC meteorite available to collectors, referring to the SNC classification of meteorite shergatites, naclites, shasignites, of which Martian meteorites belong. This meteorite is considered to be crystallized around 175 million years ago from basaltic magma. Last on the list is the Ibon meteorite. Ibon is a meteorite that fell in prehistoric times in Namibia. It was named after the nearest town, Ibon. The meteorite was discovered by the Nama people and used by them to make tools and weapons. In 1836, the English captain J.E. Alexander collected samples of the meteorite in the vicinity of the Fish River and sent them to London. There, John Herschel analyzed them and confirmed for the first time the extraterrestrial nature of the material. Between 1911 and 1913, 33 fragments of the meteorite were collected in the vicinity of Ibon and brought to the capital Windhoek. They weighed between 195 and 506 kilograms. The fragments of the meteorite in the strewn field are dispersed over an elliptical area 390 kilometers long and 120 kilometers wide. This material is classified as iron meteorite belonging to the chemical group 4A. Ibon meteorites are composed of an iron-nickel alloy containing significant amounts of cobalt and phosphorus. That's all for today. See you soon.